All right, now we've got a die that is a little more higher end, more expensive tool. This die is meant for higher production runs. So we still have the same concept of what we were looking at before. So in this case, we have our die chase here, which is made out of a more economical tool steel. In this case, this is made out of A2 hardened tool steel. And you can see these inserts that we have in here where the cutting is taking place. These inserts are put in for a couple of different reasons. One being that if something were to break or chip, we could replace just this insert without replacing the whole block. Another reason could be if there was a design change and the customer wanted to move something, we again could replace just one insert. As these inserts get sharpened, as the die wears, eventually the die life is going to get to a point where this insert is no longer functional and we need to make a new one, and we will insert that new insert will get put in there. So a few different reasons why we do that. You can see from the side that we have an A2 block. These can be made out of, depending on the type of material we're cutting and what the volumes are, this could be made out of a D2 tool steel, could be made out of A2. We use M2 quite a bit, we use CPM. It could even be carbide, depending on what the volumes are and also what the customer's budget is for their tooling. But here we have we call this the die chase, and the block below it is called the backup plate. The reason we need that is as the impact comes from this tool coming together, these smaller inserts could start to embed themselves into this die set, because the die set is made of a soft steel where these are hardened tool steel. So we need that backup plate there so that these inserts do not start to bury themselves into the die set. As we move along, we've got our pilot pier station here. The next station that comes over, this is about an inch and a quarter, inch and a half probably, of progression. So each progression on the feeder is going to move it that far forward as this thing is running. These are our pilots. These are spring loaded on this particular tool because we also have some forming stations here that are forming a leg down. So when the die comes back apart and we're about to feed our material forward, we need some clearance, otherwise this is going to bump into something down below. So that's what these are. They're spring-loaded lifters that also serve as pilot guides. As we move down, here we've got a form station here. We've got a few more trim stations in this tool. Some more forming happened down here. And then finally, as we get to the end, here is our cutoff where the part is being cut free, and then the scrap gets cut off at the end. This particular tool has die stops on it as well, much like the other one that we looked at, but in this case, there's half on each tool. For whatever reason, they did that in their design. Could be a customer preference, but you can see this one is flat. This one has the 50,000 slot in there again. On a tool like this, that is very important for us, because in this case, we have forming that's happening. And if our tool is not coming together all to the desired height, our forms will be off the, we call it being off the stops, our forms won't be hitting home and they'll be lazy, which is going to cause tolerances to be out on the final part. Here's the top half of the tool. The stripper plates are off this tool because this one is in for maintenance right now, but it gives you a chance to see the underworkings here. So here we've got a hardened, we call this the punch holder. So this punch holder also is inserted. And below the punch holder, we have that same thing with a hardened backup plate, because of these smaller punches, that impact will also cause the heads to start to sink themselves into the softer steel of the die set. Here you can see, this is the first pierce for our pilots. And here's a good example of what a pilot looks like. You've got this bullet nose on there. So as this enters the hole on the part, on the strip, it's going to do that final little location so that we know every time the die comes together, we know exactly where this part is going to be located in the tool. And that's important to make sure that all our holes, all our slots, and all our forms all line up to each other when that final part comes off the die. So these pilots go all the way down in this particular one for guiding this part along. Here we have a couple of pier stations. Now in this case, we are we're piercing a hole and then we're doing some forming. And because this is, we're only forming on one side of the part, that could cause this to want to deflect over. So this particular form, both of these have a heel on them. That's going to enter into the lower half of the die first, and it's going to help counter the forces of that punch wanting to move over so that we don't get that deflection or breakage of the part. Here's another form station as we move down. Here's what it looks like when the punch is removed. So that punch is out right now. They're probably sharpening or doing some kind of maintenance. You can see the hole in the bottom, and that's for a screw that's coming from the back. So this holds it in location. The screw holds it from falling out. We've got nitrogen springs in this case that are underneath the stripper, and that's what's going to move the stripper up and down as the press comes together. Here's a form station that's forming a ribbon to the part. Another form, little form that's in here, and here's our cutoff. And like I talked about on one of the other tools, we have these oil breakers because we run oil on dies when they're in production, and we need to get rid of that hydraulic stickiness to make sure the parts get off the punches. Here's the part that ran through that last tool. So as you can see, we needed that lift of the stock strip in order for this part to be able to go through the rest of the tool. Otherwise, we'd be banging into the sides on it. But as you can see from these examples, each of these customers had a different set of criteria that they needed to justify their ROI on their tooling. At Wisconsin Metal Parts, we design, build, and we run metal stamping dies. This is what we do all day long. If you visit us at www.wisconsinmetalparts, you can see more information about our services that we have. And if you're interested in talking about a specific part, send us your drawing and we'll take a look and we'll see if we can help find you the best solution to fit your needs.